Second to find your seats. If you would all take just a second to look up here and read this scripture. Christ in you, your hope of glory. And I would like for you to just kind of keep that in the back of your mind as we pray. If you'd like to close your eyes, whatever, or if you want to keep them open. Christ. Christ means anointed or chosen one. We, each of us, are chosen ones. Each of us has Christ in us. Each of us is love. Do you see love in everyone and everything? Through Christ's vision, we can see love in ourselves and each other. Let us see love in President Biden. Let us see love in President Trump. Let us see love in the Israeli Defense Force. Let us see love in Hamas. If I'm seeing something that upsets me, it's still there. I must need an adjustment in my seeing. Seeing through the eyes of Christ, we will see the love that's there, that's everywhere, and in everything and everyone. Let us see love. Amen.
our vision statement together. In second now, we are
realizing miracles through living our oneness with God and each other.
Thank you. Now you can sit down. Welcome to Unity of East Louisville on this rainy, rainy, week-long rain fest that we've been having. Now we don't have to worry about running out of water, right?
Right.
So welcome to Unity of East Louisville. Wherever you are on your spiritual journey, you are welcome here. We're glad to have you in your seat today. And if you're at home watching us online, we welcome you there too and hope you'll visit us sometime soon in person. Thanks to everybody who made today possible, because it takes so much more than you would know behind the scenes just to get one service done. We really appreciate the ushers and greeters who are here to greet you with a smile. If we have anybody new today, we welcome you. And if you didn't get a welcome packet but you would like one, please raise your hand and an usher or a greeter will bring you one. Thanks to our chaplains who are here to pray with you at the end of the service each and every week. Thank you to the sound and PowerPoint people this week. Les is off, so Pat is taking over on the sound, and Laura is doing the tech for us today. And we have our wonderful and faithful Don Watson here to do beautiful music. Yay, Don. Thank you, Don. And we have the lovely Elsa Hargis back again for another singing treat we get today. Thank you, Elsa, for being here. So welcome. And then we have Reverend Valerie Mansfield, Being the Mountain today. And I just wanted to say, yesterday, several of us who were here today were at the retreat, and it was wonderful. And Valerie put in a lot of energy. Well, a lot of people did put in a lot of time and energy. And we thank you, Valerie. That was fantastic. To all of you who put that together, I think it was half of Unity East women, but you guys did a great job. And Valerie's got all this energy, and now she's back to speak again today. So thanks, Valerie. And before I leave that subject, did anybody who went yesterday leave a Fitbit at the retreat? Because if you did, Colleen's got it. You did. Okay, well, there you go.
Actually,
somebody's got it. Anyway, somebody's got it. All right, great. We got one solved, one problem today. That's just awesome.
Yay.
All right, and if you would turn off your cell phones, please, if you haven't already done so. Today's Hope and Compassion Collection, the basket is down front here. It supports the Eastern Area Community Ministries, which houses the Dare to Care Food Bank. And we support them through food collection and also things like toiletries and other essentials. But the money actually goes to them to use, I believe, Pat, if this is correct, they use the money for helping with housing rent payments if people can't make them. So we really appreciate your donations to that. We give one supporter. And then Maryhurst Girls Home, we also donate to them to whatever they need. And then the last one that I always say the wrong things, Peaceful Cities Project, Numinous, I believe is the name of the organization. And we supported them through our prayer and meditations, whatever you want to call it, study that we did last fall. And we'll support them again next year, because the meditation that we do as a group actually has been shown to bring down the violence levels or the crime levels in an area. So that is a really special one. We also support Crosby Middle School, but we do that separately through donations now based on what they need specifically, like we did sweatshirts or items to go in backpacks or things like that. So we'll do that separately at another time. Anytime anybody wants to bring any donations in for Eastern Area Community Ministries in the form of food or toiletries or cleaning products, you can put them under the counter over there, and I'll make sure they get to Eastern Area Community Ministries, otherwise known as EACM. That collection for Hope and Compassion, if you want to write your check to Unity of East Louisville, just make sure to put Hope and Compassion in your memo line so that Angeline knows where it's going. So that will be after our regular collection. So once the ushers and greeters take the regular bag collection up and down the aisles, then after that, we'll start to move forward to put the donations in the basket. That's a mouthful. Sorry about all that information. Sometimes just the way it is. Thank you. Today, after the service, right after the service, you're going to do an usher greeter meeting. So anybody who would like to be an usher greeter can stay after and learn how to do that. They're going to go over the basics with you. February 11th, we're going to have, it's Pinky Jackson, right?
Pinky Jackson.
She's coming to speak on decluttering your physical space to declutter your spiritual space. And that will be, she'll speak and also do a workshop afterwards. So that's February 11th, otherwise known as Super Bowl Sunday, for those of you who are thinking about that, planning your day. So you may want to declutter your physical space so you can watch the Super Bowl that night in just peace and quiet. All right, and then we have the strategic planning meeting. I'm going to keep telling you about this so you won't forget. It's Saturday, February 24th from 10 to 2, so we'd like to see as many people as possible for that. Amazing Powers Within is a workshop that Val's going to be doing, and that's starting Wednesdays, February 21st. It'll go through March 27th, and that'll be 6 to 8 p.m. on Wednesdays. All of this is on the weekly email or on the website. If you're not on the weekly email and you'd like to be on it, please sign up at the back. And also, to get the flock notes, put down your phone number if you'd like to get the flock note that tells you in case anything important is going on or anything that we have to change. I think that's it for the announcements. You can breathe a sigh of relief now. Yay, I got one yay. All right, let's do some silly jokes. Don told me how much he missed being able to pick out the silly dad joke of the week, so I'm not going to deprive him of that pleasure anymore. Let's see, that's one we already read before, Don. Shoot, I had that still in there. All right, which award was given to the inventor of knock-knock jokes? I didn't do this one already.
Do that again, I didn't hear it.
Which award was given to the inventor of knock-knock jokes? The Nobel Prize. Groan. Why did the woman get fired from the calendar factory? She took a day off. Thank you. Thanks to Pauline for giving me the dad jokes. And then Wynn has been sending me all kinds of cute jokes, and so a couple of them I'll be able to read here. This one's real. I thought this one was cute. Sometimes someone unexpected comes into your life out of nowhere, makes your heart race, and changes you forever. We call these people cops. Greet each other in love and joy this morning. Some people weren't laughing at that.
Thank you.
bill.
Choices is the key to my freedom. No one and nothing can make me feel a certain way. Living from this awareness gives me the power to create my life from the inside out. I choose my thoughts, my words, and actions. If I don't like what my life is showing me, I have the power to make the choices. I do not squander my spiritual freedom. Other people in worldly situations have no control over me. Taking full responsibility for my life, I am free to create my future by living from my divinity. As servants of God, live as free people, yet do not use your freedom as a pretext for evil. Chapter 1 Peter 2:16. And so it is.
Our Creator. which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be breathing in the light, and allowing that to gently flow down into our solar plex, to that seat of wisdom, that seat of all knowing, the seat of guidance. Right above the navel. And just visualize this beautiful sunlight flowing in and settling in that solar plexus region, in that seat of wisdom and expanding, just as the sun comes into you and lights you up and warms you, embracing you and expanding throughout your whole being, the truth of yourself, the all-knowing presence that is alive and active in you right now. Breathing in and breathing out. So breathing in that beautiful yellow, that energy of wisdom. The energy of right choices. Letting go, breathing out. let go of any supposed outcome and live in the flow, knowing the right and perfect direction is already active within us. And we rest and listen in the silence. And as we breathe in, acknowledging the presence of the oneness of all that is, of that Christ self that is in us, following the guidance. We are open and receptive to all the good. Being present and feeling the freedom of the awakening, of the wisdom that is alive and active in each of us right now. We are free. We are unlimited. And we live in the flow of the Almighty. Standing in truth as love, with understanding. We send peace into the world.
To kill.
With that flu that's going around, so we see everyone in that space of fullness and health, that divine nature that is our truth, as we get through these winter months into that spring, which I saw a beautiful picture this morning on Facebook that Rebecca had posted in the Cox's Creek. It might have been yesterday, but it was a beautiful imagery of the creek and the fall and rolling up and that spring coming forth, the birds are chirping, very beautiful. So, are we really open to the unlimited possibilities? And are we willing to take action to create that, to manifest it in our life? And really, Marge's opening prayer this morning kind of was the talk in Unfoldable. She hit it right on the nose of who we really are, that Christ self unfolding in the wisdom and love of everything that is. And so how do we be the mountain, right? How do we stand tall in our faith and in our beliefs and in everything that we are and stand in our truth? Because when I was looking at this, you know, gathering my thoughts this morning, and I looked at the title, I'm thinking, oh man, what was I thinking? Be in the mountain. Really, what's that about today? And it was really about the judgment and wisdom, and I was doing it right in that moment. So how many times do we look at something and we judge it? We judge everything. And judgment has gotten a really bad rap in our society because we think it's negative. But in reality, it is the creative wisdom when we discern and make choices. Whether we look at them as good choices or bad choices, we really don't know in the moment that we're choosing what's going to come, right? Does anybody know when they make a choice which path they're going down? I don't. And so there's this thing about judgment, even to the point where if you look in 12 Powers, I mean, when Charles Fillmore first started naming the faculties and what they were and how they resonate within our own nervous system and our energy systems and our body, he looked at it as judgment. But it was that discernment and then taking action with that discernment and moving forward, no matter what it was, because we don't know. And taking action into justice and really begin to live as the being. And I have phrased it as a mountain because when we stand in our truth, anything is possible, and we cannot be shattered or broken. So we are this mountain of faith and strength that is unfolding as wisdom. And in our society, what I notice is that because of the allegory of Adam and Eve, anybody heard that story? And the tree of knowledge, that the man and woman were told by wisdom not to eat, not to enter into the consciousness of the fruit of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, right? But the pleasure of sensation, that serpent, that animal consciousness of pleasure tempted them and they ate. In reality, the serpent represents that alive substance, that materialistic world. But in reality, we have these sensations, we have these feelings, we have this affection, we have this love. It's part of our nature. It's not bad. It's part of who we are. We can't separate from it. With wisdom comes love. They're intertwined. And if you look at the apostles, James of Zebedee, son of Zebedee, represents wisdom, and John represents love. Well, they're brothers, and they're called the sons of thunder, because when the two meet, right, when the solar plex and the heart chakras meet, what happens? Any of you guys ever do any energetic work? What about the women that were at the retreat yesterday? When you combine and you move from your solar plex into your heart, what happens? There's this amazing opening of reality that is not materialistic. It's energetic. It's spiritual. It's what moves us up into the spiritual nature of our truth as the mountain. It moves us up into a higher consciousness so that we can perceive things from the spiritual realm instead of the physical realm, instead of the materialistic world. Because what has happened with the story of Adam and Eve, Jesus told us that there was a day of judgment. A day of judgment. So a moment in time when we have to make a choice, not the judgment day. Not that we are going to be judged. So there's a huge difference between a time of judgment when we have to individually make choices and a judgment day when we're being judged. Because the judgment day is all about control, and it's about keeping us in the materialistic world as reality, as the only world. And that's not the truth. We don't just live in the reality of the materialistic world, in the human consciousness world. That's not who we are. We live in this multifaceted dimension of spiritualness, of spiritual consciousness, which allows us to discern our own path and our own way. And when we go into that seat of wisdom and intuitively are guided by that still small voice, sitting. So how many of you guys have had because you're out of balance. You're living from that humanness and you're confused because every time you make a choice, it's not the right path, because we're choosing from that human consciousness that is not truth with a capital T. It's not real with a capital R. We have to go back into our spiritual being. We have to go back and align ourselves into that place where we hear the still small voice. Because when we're not hearing the still small voice, we're not being guided spiritually. We're not connecting with that higher power that is you in action. We're judging ourselves based on race consciousness instead of living from our spiritual self. When we allow ourselves to listen to that still small voice, a light breaks through. It breaks through and starts to seep in and expand and clear away the darkness and guide you into joy and for this energy and this uplift. But when we're living from that human consciousness, we're really shutting it down. And so if you really want to live in the ecstasy of life and that joy and that power that is you, we have to do it from our spiritual nature, from that seat of wisdom. That's where all the action happens. And that's why you don't hear about it in traditional churches. How many of y'all hear about your chakra system and energy flowing through you? Well, if you're not flowing spiritually, you have all these blocks. They're presently blocked in your physical being, and that's what creates dis-ease in our body, because we're not connected from our head to our toe. We're disconnected. And your solar plex is the middle of your being. It is the seat of action of all that is. It is your intuitive self, that guidance. And so many of us were told that it's not true, that that voice we heard is not real. And it's the only thing to begin to open up in you. Right? Because that's what it's about. It's about getting rid of all those error thinking and all of that stuff. That's why we go through what we've gone through with the burning bowl and the new name. And everything that we do is intentional so that we can open our being up to begin again to listen, just as we did as children, to that still small voice. The difference is we know that it's real. It is the reality for our spiritual being to rise up in consciousness. So Jesus took Peter, James, and John, which is faith, wisdom, and love, up into the mountains and was transfigured before them. When we realize the spiritual possibilities, we are lifted up. And all of our faculties are lifted up. So then we're lifted up and being the mountain. Because nothing can stop us when we are all in alignment and listening to guidance from that spiritual high watch that is the mountain. The wisdom that is above is pure. First pure, and then peaceable. It's a quote from the 12 Powers book. The wisdom that is from above is first pure, then peaceable. When we call our inner forces into action, the universe aligns and works for and with us. So when we call ourselves into alignment, and we're peaceful within our own being, and we're living from that nature, that natural space, It flows into the world as peace, as love. It can do nothing other than that. And when enough of us stand in our truth and in alignment, that's when the world transforms, is transfigured, just as Jesus when he went to the mountain. So we all have to be aligned together to have peace in our world. Yes, we see the love in everyone. That is part of the learning. Even if we're not in alignment with the thinking, we don't hold thoughts, right? If we didn't recognize it, we wouldn't see it. And so we have to be in alignment to overcome the challenges, to overcome the old thinking. And when enough of us are in alignment, that's when it shifts. So continue to do your own work to align your life. And I'm going to end with a quote from the 12 Powers book. It's the last paragraph in the book for wisdom. The wisdom of the Christ mind is active through my recognition of Christ's identity and unified with God. Wisdom, judgment, discrimination, purity, and power are here now, expressing themselves in the beauty of holiness. The justice, righteousness, and peace of Christ's mind now harmonizes wisely, direct, and surely establish the kingdom of God in my body temple. There are no more worrying contentions through me. For the peace of God is here established, and the Lion and the Lamb, which is courage and innocence, sit on the throne of the dominion with wisdom and love. I love you. I bless you. I behold the living Christ as you. Namaste.
Always gonna
great song to go with Valerie's talk. Oh, I chilled. Now it's time to take your offering in your hand as we say the blessing together. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. And after the chaplains go through, anybody else can bring their money up for the open compassion. Thank you.
These generous gifts from all of these loving souls here today. We are so blessed. Thank you. Amen.
Our prayer chaplains are here to pray with you after the service. So they have on the lashes. Here comes Kathy. Whoever else is going to be here. So they're here to just hold you in that space of love and light. And now we're going to stand for a prayer for protection. I guess I'll finish the service off. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. Thank you, God. And now we'll do our peace song.
Peace that was meant to be with God.